Okay, I hope that's good. Let me grab the book. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So with this new year of 2019, I was wanting to do a different kind of style of wrap-up video. So I am here today because I finished Colleen Hoover's Verity just a couple days ago. Today is, I think, January 3rd, and I read this book on January 1st as a readathon. So we read the whole book together, me and my book club, and then we discussed it in a live discussion later on. So now I kind of have some time to like process this book. One of the things that I'm doing differently this year is instead of like at the end of the month sitting down and going through all of the books that I read that month in a like a wrap up, I wanted to do it every time I finished a book because I just feel like my thoughts are more fresh and I know what's going, like I just know what I'm thinking instead of waiting to the end. Sometimes I read, you know, so many books that I don't remember the first book, like really what I disliked or liked about it. So I'm hoping that this works out really well. If you have any tips or you want to see me do anything specific, just pop them down in the comments. Let me know because I really don't know how this is going to go. I guess I'll just sit down every couple days when I finish a book and talk to you guys. How about that? So let's get into it. I finished Verity by Colleen Hoover. My actual rating on Goodreads, I decided to go a little further up and I gave it 4 stars because it is Colleen Hoover and she is one of my favorites. But I actually felt like this was more of a 3.5 star read for me. So that's what I wrote in my little like review on Goodreads. And the reason being is this is her first romance thriller novel. So this was kind of labeled as a psychological thriller. And I just don't feel like it should have been called that. I think that it was more a romance, maybe suspense. But I know that for some of the people that read this with me, they were kind of newer to the thriller genre. So for them, it was very like fast paced and exciting for them to read. But for me, I read a lot of like more dark, creepier psychological thrillers. And so for me, it was just kind of like, okay, you know, whatever. I'm not going to be giving any spoilers because this is a wrap-up video, so I don't want to talk too much about this kind of stuff. But like always, I'm going to say for this whole entire year, if there are any specific books that you do want me to do a review on and have like a little spoilery section, just let me know because I would be happy for doing that. I have no clue. I think I'm terrible at giving reviews, but hey, you guys might like it. So this is gonna be spoiler free. So some of the things that I didn't like about this book was that it was hard to get into. I felt like it wasn't until I was like a quarter or a third of the way of the book until I kind of started to want to keep reading because it was very easy to put down in the beginning. That's one of the ways that I kind of like rate a book is if I am just so hooked into it that I don't, you know, pull my phone out or I don't think about how hungry I am or thirsty or how cold my coffee is or like things like that. And so this one I didn't find that really happened. So that was a little disappointing. And then another thing that was disappointing was it just didn't ever get to like the twisting parts. Like the twists I kind of were able to guess. I felt like I just knew what was going to happen. There wasn't anything that was super surprising. And then the ending was just not very, I don't know. It wasn't very satisfying either. Like it just kind of ended without really knowing. I don't know. It's hard to explain without giving any spoilers, but let me go ahead and talk about some of the things that I did like about it. Number one, I love the way that Colleen Hoover writes. Like she is just very like, I don't know, it's easy reading, like there's not too much description and I just really enjoy her writing. Since she is my favorite author, that is a reason why I rated it a little higher as well because I think she deserves it. She does. Number two, there actually was more romance in here than I thought. A lot of people said that there wasn't, but for me, there was more romance and it was kind of like 50 Shades Grey, raunchy type. I was fine with that. Like it wasn't anything that, you know, turned me off from the book. So for me, that was a positive thing because I think that Colleen Hoover writes more raunchier things better than other people. Like I didn't feel like it was very cheesy, I should say. But if you're one of the people that doesn't like a 50 Shades Grey type of thing, then you probably shouldn't read this. And then the other thing that I kind of liked was that the way that she did have the book set up, there's a bunch of like different theories going around. And so I guess it was really fun to have a live discussion with my friends that read this with me. It made me appreciate and like the book more because I heard what other people kind of like got from it. And so I feel like Colleen Hoover did that, you know, pretty well with just kind of like making it so that you're not just reading it one way and it has to be that way. So, you know, that is a positive thing, I feel like, where, you know, the ending isn't just the ending that everyone thinks. It could be a bunch of different endings. I would love to see her write a sequel to this book. And I feel like if she wrote a sequel and made the sequel kind of answer questions from this book and just kind of like blew our minds in it, I would rate this book a lot higher because it was the fact that it just got left there. I have no clue if she's writing a sequel and just buy this book, like if it's just a standalone. I felt like it just wasn't as good as it could be. Those are my thoughts on This Verity by Colleen Hoover. This is the only book that I finished so far this year. It's January 3rd. I am making my way through like 3 other books right now, so hopefully I can update you guys later if I finish one, and if not, I'll see you in a couple days.
Hopefully that's not gonna fall over.
It's been a couple days, and yes, I'm sick. I was trying to hold off on doing my reviews for the last couple books that I've read for this month, but I'm just, my voice is just gonna sound terrible. So, since the last time I think I updated, I've actually finished a couple more books. And so I'm on a roll. Today is actually January 10th, and I'm about to start my 6th book this month, which is Our Kind Cruelty. I've not started it yet, but I just finished Kilman Creek. And so I'm gonna go through these ones that I finished so far. So a couple days I finished The Happiness Project by Gretchen Rubin. And this is a nonfiction book that I was reading for my keto motivation group. I think I ended up giving it 3 stars. It was actually a pretty easy read, and I did like some of the things that she talked about in here because like she was talking about just trying to be happier in general, what you could do in your life. So a lot of this stuff seemed to kind of be like New Year's resolution type things, like, you know, I don't know, tidy up your house every day for 10 minutes or read a book or start a club or I don't know, things like that. The only thing was she kind of did like 5 or 6 things each month. Like she would focus on a month, say February was, you know, helping her marriage get better, and she would then focus on like 5 or 6 things that would like help her get to that. But the thing was like I felt that throughout the year I wouldn't be able to keep up with my previous months. So the 5 things that she did in January, she added on to the 5 things she also was doing in February. So by the end of the year, you're doing, you know, a million different things every single day to try to make your life happier. And I just didn't feel like that part was realistic. She also just kind of says like, do it. So for people that have problems with like willpower and stuff like that, I didn't feel like it was very, I don't know, like you just wouldn't be able to stick to it just being like, oh, well, in January, I'm gonna do these 5 things, and in February, I'm gonna do these 5 things. Like, it just doesn't work out that way, especially for people that have full-time jobs. Like, she's just a writer, and she lives in New York City, so I just felt like she doesn't know where other people are coming from and, you know, what other people are doing in their own lives. I feel like if you read The Power of Habit, which I actually read in December, that book is way better, talking about like how you can actually like hit your goals and have more willpower and start new habits. And so I highly recommend reading that one before you would even read this one if this is something that sounds like you would want to read. The next book that I read was The Lies We Told by Camilla Way. I think I might have given this 4 stars. It was a little boring at first with, it actually has like 2 different stories in it, and then at the end they kind of like collide and you find out like what is going on. But the one story is about this like little girl that is like really mean to her mom, and it literally reminds me of Baby Teeth. And if you've watched some of my previous like review videos, you'll realize that I didn't really like Baby Teeth because the girl was a brat. Now in this book, I think that she did a little bit better job at like writing that part of the story, and that story was actually the interesting one. And then the other story was about this like girlfriend that loses her boyfriend, like he disappears and she has no clue like where he goes. And eventually all these stories like tie together, and I felt like that story was actually pretty boring until maybe the second half. And then once
things kind of started happening, it was a lot better. But I was surprised by the ending. It was actually a pretty good ending, so I do like recommend this book. It actually was pretty good. It just wasn't like the best thriller that I've ever read. Then I read She Was the Quiet One by Michelle Campbell, and this is actually the second book that I read by Michelle Campbell. It's Always the Husband is the first book, and I'm pretty sure I gave that 4 stars because it was actually a pretty good read. And this one I rated 5 stars. I actually really liked this. Every time I like had to put it down for something, I just remember wanting to pick it back up to read it again. It wasn't a super like fast or crazy thriller, and like the ending wasn't a shocker, but it was just the story in itself. Like, it was a very easy read. I felt like I connected with the characters, and I just always found myself wanting to read it. Like, I was just drawn to the story. It kind of reminded me of like a Pretty Little Liars / Gossip Girl / 13 Reasons Why, because it deals with twin sisters that go to the same school. One of the twin sisters is like rebellious and does bad things, and the other one is good. And the bad one starts like kind of having a student teacher affair. You know, the good one doesn't want her to break up like the marriage between those people. And so it's a pretty crazy read. Like, I really, really enjoyed this, and I highly recommend it if you're a thriller lover. Let's get to the real one right here. I just finished this today. This is Kilman Creek. This is actually the second book of the Still House Lake series, and I highly, highly recommend the Still House Lake series. Like, just go out and buy it or read it or get it at your library or do something, because I am not a series reader. Like, I don't know if you know, but I hardly ever read series because I don't know, I want to find out the answers. I just feel like a lot of times series are just drug out. I don't know. But I read Still House Creek last month, I think it was in December. And I just freaking loved that book. Like, it was amazing. If I could give it 6 stars, I would, because it literally felt like a psychopath was chasing me the whole entire time. Like, anxiety driven craziness. So it was so, so good. It's a psychological thriller. You don't know who to trust in the books. Absolutely crazy. So this is the second book to that. And again, same exact thing. Feeling it's like the story is continuing. So you don't know who to trust. You don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know, it's just crazy. And the third book comes out, I think, May 23rd. So it's definitely a book that like I absolutely have to like go and get, because I just cannot wait to find out like the end to this series. I just love it so much. I wouldn't change a thing. I have nothing bad to say about this series. And I just think that every single person that even remotely likes a thriller book should read this series, because it is so, so good. Like, it's just so good. It's just amazing. Those were the last couple books that I read over the last couple days. And like I said, I'm gonna start Our Kind Cruelty. This one I saw at the library and I picked it up, and it just sounds really good. So I'm excited to get to this one. So I'll see you in a couple days.
So it's been a few days, I feel like, since I've kind of like updated you guys. Today is January 21st and I've only finished 2 books since the last time I updated you guys. So these are book 5 and 6, I believe. I'm about like 3/4 of the way through Maybe Now by Colleen Hoover, but that's an ebook. So I'm hoping to finish that like pretty soon. But I finished Her One Mistake by Heidi Perks. This was sent to me by one of my friends in my book club, and she said that like I would really like it because it was like a crazy thriller. And I now forget what I rated it on Goodreads, but I'm pretty sure I rated it a 4. It was really good, actually. There were a lot of like twists and turns that I didn't see coming. I did find it a little like confusing at first in the beginning, just the way that the like POVs were written. But once I like kind of got through the beginning and I kind of like understood kind of what was going on or who was saying what, or you know, got familiar with names, then it was a lot better. And this was about this one, like these two moms. They both had kids, and the one mom was going to watch the other mother's daughter, and so she took like all her kids and the daughter to the fair and ended up losing her friend's daughter. And it goes through like, you know, who kidnapped the child. There's just really weird, shady, like the people are very, very shady in this book. The ending was very good. So this is like a 4, 4.5 star for me. I do recommend this one. And then the next one that I read, this one actually, my sister-in-law, she works at Books A Million now, and she's able to literally get whatever book she wants there and like check it out almost like a library, and you can have it for 2 weeks. You can only do one book at a time, but she got this book, which is No Exit by Taylor Adams. Everyone's been talking about it. It was a book of the month pick, I think, back in December, I believe, and everyone was saying how amazing it was. So I asked her to pick it up for me, and I literally read it in one day. I just read this yesterday. This was a 5-star read for me. I loved it so much. It was about this girl that was like driving in this like snowmageddon thing, and she lost a windshield wiper, so she had to stop at a rest stop and ended up getting snowed in at this rest stop along with a couple other people, and you know, listening to like a little bit of the radio that they could actually hear, they figured out that the plows weren't going to be coming for another like 10 hours, so they were going to have to stay there pretty much all night. And so there was no cell service or anything at all. They were just like drinking coffee and like playing cards. And she realized that when she went out to like go to her vehicle, that one of the vans had a little girl like locked in a dog cage in the van. So it comes to like, she comes to find out that like one of the people that's at the rest stop is a kidnapper. And it was just a crazy, crazy story after that. There were so many twists and turns that I didn't see coming. And even the ending like threw me off. I had to read the ending like 2 or 3 times just to figure out like if I needed to be angry or not. So highly recommend this book, No Exit. I really, really enjoyed this. Yeah, I've been reading like so many good books this month. It's really crazy. Like I was looking back at what I put on Goodreads so far, and I've had a lot of like 4 and 5 star books. So this wrap up I feel like is gonna be pretty spectacular. Right now, like I said, I'm gonna be finishing Maybe Now, but I was actually getting my books kind of ready for February's TBR. That video has already come out. It's about me doing Bookopoly, and you can watch it. I'll have it up above and down below, but it's gonna be super, super exciting. So right now I'm actually not sure what I'm going to read next after I finish Maybe Now. I'm probably just gonna like kind of go with some of my stacks that I already have for Bookopoly, just to kind of like get things going. Really quick, I did want to say that I am 159 pages in The Woman in the Window, but I had to stop because I really, really despised this book and how it was written, and it was very slow. So I'm supposed to be finishing it with a buddy, but at the moment I really do not like this book. So if I finish this and I end up liking it, at least I can go back and say I was wrong. But for now, I despise it. Okay, so today is actually February 1st, and I did not get to like film for the last couple days of the last couple books that I've read. And so I actually just finished reading The Woman in the Window. This literally took me all of January to read because it was so incredibly bad. I ended up rating it 2 stars just because the ending was a little bit better. Like at least I kind of enjoyed the ending. Like when I say enjoyed for this book, like I'm talking like the least amount of enjoyment is how much I enjoyed it. Number one, it was a huge book. I was at page like 159 and nothing had happened yet. It was so boring. I hated the way that the sentences were like so, so choppy. Like it hurt so much to just read this book. And then I hated the characters. I hated the story. Like I don't know why people like it so much. I just really do not like it. Like I could have gone without reading this book. I read it now, whatever. I guess I can say that, whatever. It's about this like lady that she doesn't know, like she witnesses this like murder or whatever, but she like can't go outside. She's like in her house. So she witnesses this like murder of her neighbors because she like stalks her neighbors like with her camera. She calls 911 and everyone's like, you're crazy because you're on medication and you're drinking and stuff. And so like literally all you're doing, like you spend most of the book just reading about like this crazy lady and like what she does every day. It's just so crazy. Like
whatever. Okay, so another book that I read was An Anonymous Girl. I will just pop it up on the screen because I got it from Books A Million, so I already gave it back for Lindsay to take. I did really like this book. I gave it 4 stars. It's kind of like, I thought it was like gonna be like a sci-fi thriller. It turned out to be more of a thriller than sci-fi at all, but it has to do with this like survey that's being done from like women that are like 18 to 24 or 27 or something like that. And it's all about like your morals and like how you answer questions. So this girl goes to like take this survey, and these questions are like really, I don't know, just really weird, like based on things that like have happened in her life. So you're kind of like wondering like what happened in her life, what is going on with this whole like doctor person that like made this survey. The reason I didn't give it 5 stars is because I thought like the writing was amazing. It was really, really good. And it kept me reading. Like, I think I finished this in like a day or a day and a half. But then what I didn't like was like the ending just fell short. I thought more things were going to happen. I thought there was going to be some twists. I thought I was, you know, what I thought was going on in the book, I thought was going to be different at the end, and it wasn't. So I took a star off for that because I just really like being surprised at the ending. Like, that's one of the reasons why I read thrillers. I think I rated those authors, like the first book, The Wife Between Us, I'm pretty sure I gave the same like kind of 4-star rating. And I think I remember feeling the same way. Like, the writing was really good, it kept me reading, but then it just always falls short for the ending. So that was a 4-star read for me. And then I also read Elevation by Stephen King. I'll just pop it up again because I already took it back to the library. This one was a 1-star. It was absolutely terrible. I've never read a Stephen King book. I tried reading The Shining back in October. I hated it. I was so bored. So I saw this Elevation book at the library, and I was like, it's small, it's short, I can do this. And especially because I needed to get points to like for my book club challenge that was going on. I started reading it, hated it. I hate the way that he like writes. It literally sounds like an old man, like a grandpa is like literally telling you his life story and you don't even know him. Like, he like, I don't know, you work at a coffee shop and he just comes in and like starts rambling on about his life. That's literally what it was like. And then the story was just so weird. It's about this like man that starts becoming weightless. Like, he's like losing weight, but without losing weight. Like, he looks exactly the same. He looks like he's still 240 pounds, but he like gets down to like 137, and like things that he holds are like weightless. It was so stupid. I wasted my time reading that book, but I had to finish it because I needed those points for the challenge. Don't read it, people. It was bad. And then I finished 2 like Bible study type books. One was Understanding the Holy Spirit, and this one I actually won on Goodreads. And so it was just like a giveaway book. I think I ended up giving it like 1 star, I believe. It literally was just Bible verses and then the lady explaining, like rewriting the Bible verses in her own words. And so I literally didn't like, I didn't learn anything from it. And I just didn't like the way that it was. Like, I thought I was gonna learn something. I thought it was gonna be deeper. I thought I could use it as a Bible study, but maybe it would be good for beginners. I'm not sure, but I did not like that. And then the other one that I was reading was Uninvited. This was my first book by Lysa, and I just think I picked one that wasn't for me. I think I gave it 2 stars, but it was more about like feeling lonely and like you're rejected or whatever, and I don't feel that way. So I liked her style of writing. It kind of reminded me of Rachel Hollis, but I like Rachel Hollis better just because I felt like I actually like knew what she was talking about, and I was like, yeah, like I feel that way or whatever. But this book I just didn't, so I didn't really like that book either. Oh, and then I also forgot that I read Maybe Now by Colleen Hoover. Colleen Hoover is one of my all-time favorite authors, and Maybe Now is like the second book to Maybe Someday. Now, she does have Maybe Not, which is just like a novella, and I've read that one too. I've read all of those. I gave it 3 stars. It was good, like it was cute. I like the way that Colleen Hoover writes, but all in all, I just felt, I don't know, I just don't really like her like second, like her number 2s of books or her novellas. There's just not as much like emotion or deep writing as there is in her like first books all the time. So it was just like, okay, I wouldn't like, I could have gone without reading it.
because it wasn't even really about the main character. It was about like a side character. So I just don't really like that very much. So that is all for my reading wrap up for January. I actually finished it with 13 books, even though I started reading The Woman in the Window like a while ago and I just finished it today. I had like 150 pages left, so I'm counting it in January. So I finished 13 books. I read some really, really good ones. And so all in all, I am like, I'm happy with how I read in January. Let me know down in the comments if you have a book that you read this month that you want to recommend to me, and I will definitely try and put it on my list. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.